Coming up on a special edition of Microsoft Mechanics, we look at how you can run your VMware workloads natively on Azure with the new Azure VMware solution, which is now generally available. And to explain more, I'm joined today by Matt McSpirit, who's no stranger to Microsoft Mechanics. Welcome back to the show.
Thanks, Jeremy. It's great to be back.
So why don't we get right into this? Because we've had the ability to migrate VMware environments to Azure for a while now, but what's different now with the new Azure VMware solution?
So the new Azure VMware solution, or AVS, is a fully managed Microsoft first-party Azure PaaS service that lets you run your VMware environment natively in Azure, essentially VMware in the cloud, using your existing investments in the VMware ecosystem of tools and processes. It's just VMware as you know it, and it's endorsed by VMware.
Okay, so why don't we drill into the details? What's new about the new iteration of this?
So for starters, this is an entirely Microsoft-developed and supported solution that has deep native integration with Azure. And of course, we'll take care of managing and updating your environment so that you can focus on running your VMware workloads. And what's also great is you can use this solution on your terms, either being completely in the cloud or in a hybrid configuration combined with on-prem VMware. Now, the best part is you can integrate your VMware workloads with native Azure services, like, for example, using Azure Blob Storage for storing things like VM templates.
And this is really a good use case because you won't be using your premium storage in vSAN for objects that can be stored in lower tier storage at lower cost. And it's unlimited in Azure. So I can see lots of scenarios that would really open up here. It'd be useful, for example, if you wanted to add capacity in the cloud to avoid hardware refresh costs. Maybe you want to increase your seasonal capacity or even replicate your policies in VMs in Azure as part of your disaster recovery or business continuity strategies. And it also helps as more and more of us are working remotely today, but how would I get started?
So in most cases, you probably already have an existing VMware environment. So for example, here I've got a pretty typical vSphere environment, and let's assume that this is my on-prem VMware. This is my starting point, and I want to move either parts or all of it into Azure.
Okay, so everyone's vSphere environment, I think, is a bit unique, but how do I know then how to right-size that environment when I bring it into Azure?
Great question. Now, to make it easy, we've expanded Azure Migrate to now also include support for Azure VMware solution. Now, to find this, I'm just going to start by searching for Migrate. And there it is, and I'll select the Azure Migrate option. Now, this feature is currently in public preview and includes both the discovery and assessment phase. Discovery is used to import your server inventory, and assessments are essentially what will output the required sizing. So I'll click into servers and discover. And when you start a discovery, you can either use the appliance VM method for an accurate performance-based assessment of your existing VMware environment, or you can simply upload your VMware inventory with basic VM information from a CSV file. Now, here's a CSV file, and you'll see some pretty standard VM specs and performance metrics that we'll use to calculate the assessment. Now, I already have one assessment that I created earlier, and you'll see that in this case, I need 4 nodes for the 12 VMs in my assessment. Now, assessments can represent either a single application or workload or your entire VMware estate. And here, I'm just assessing a single app with just a few VMs. Now, if I click into Edit Properties, I can adjust the VMware and Azure-specific settings, such as storage policy settings and or CPU oversubscription, in addition to choosing the right location and node size. But once I feel good about the recommendations and my inputs, I can click back into my assessment, and here we have a link straight to the AVS service to create a new private cloud.
How easy is it then to create a new private cloud in Azure?
So the experience is similar to provisioning other Azure services in the portal. As you can see here, the link has taken me straight to the private cloud create blade in the Azure portal. So I'll fill in the standard Azure Resource Manager fields, as well as specify the credentials needed for the vCenter environment and some network specific settings.
So how long does the provisioning or build process then take?
Well, that's going to take about an hour, but compare that to setting up your VMware environment on premises, where it could take weeks to install everything needed. Now, to save time, let's move on to one I set up earlier. So let me show you a fully provisioned vSphere environment in Azure and how closely we've integrated with Azure. I can easily manage my connectivity settings, such as my network config from on-prem via ExpressRoute, or grab my HCX required configuration for configuring and activating the HCX service that we'll use for VM migration later. In Identity, I can get the link to my vCenter, NSX Manager, and passwords. And for managing additional capacity in my clusters, I can simply edit the sizing here in the Azure portal. I can see the number of nodes I have and choose to edit the number of ESXi hosts with a simple slider, but I'm going to keep it at 4 for now. And also to support disaster recovery, or DR, we now have a new add-on blade, which enables you to deploy the VMware Site Recovery Manager appliance straight from the portal, and we'll have other add-on offerings showing up soon. Additionally, we've also built support for AVS via the Azure CLI using the VMware extension. So I'm in my jump box now where I'll run this CLI command for clusters with a dash H. And as you can see, we can easily and programmatically configure or add nodes to our cluster. Now, remember the Azure Blob storage we talked about earlier? I can see reference to that in my content library here in vSphere. So I'll hop into my content library settings, and instead of an internal data store, you'll see the subscription URL is actually pointing to an Azure Blob resource. And if we go back to the Azure portal, I can show you the Azure Blob storage objects in that resource. In this case, you can see my VM templates in my Azure Blob store, and this can be accessible to all my VMware private clouds if I choose.
Okay, so if I wanted then to migrate some VM workloads into the new Azure hosted vSphere environment, what does that process look like?
Right, so let's migrate a VM from my on-prem environment to Azure using HCX. So HCX is deployed as part of the AVS private cloud and is the standard tool used for VMware to VMware migrations, supporting the many scenarios you might have. Now, in my case, I've got two sites set up, as you can see in this view of the site connections.
Right, so now you can move one or more of those VMs then between each site like we just saw on the map.
Yeah, that's right. So let me show you how simple it is. So now we're going to perform a VM migration using HCX. And in this demo, I've configured all HCX connections in advance. Here in the vSphere client, you can see the source virtual machine. So I'll just right-click and choose HCX actions and select migrate to target site. I'm going to select the required configuration options for my target destination, like my compute container, migration type, which could be single or bulk migration, my destination storage, and then I'll click on go. Of course, for large-scale migrations, we can migrate several VMs at a time and even application groups. And HCX can also serve as a manual DR function. So we'll take a look at our migration monitor, and we've sped things up a little bit to save some time, but you can see that our VM is now migrated into our AVS target site.
Okay, so now that you're in Azure, then what can I do or what I need to do if I want to connect to other Azure services?
Well, now that you've got your workloads in Azure, you can connect your VMware workloads to the entire Azure ecosystem with its deep integration. You can leverage our partner ecosystem with support for things like backup and business continuity solutions from partners like Veeam, Veritas, and Commvault.
Where is Azure VMware solution available today?
So the service is currently available in the US, Europe, Australia, and other regions including Japan, Canada, UK, and Southeast Asia are coming soon. And you can learn more about the solution at aka.ms/getAVS and find everything you need to get started with building your vSphere private cloud in Azure today.
Thanks, Matt. And hopefully we answered all of your questions. And don't forget to subscribe to Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.